Trying to figure butt of these 10 times. And when you're so keep going back and keep finding more things, and I want to suggest to people they go to cemeteries because you get so much information about families. And in the case of San Antonio, there were all the families are related. I mean, I didn't know who they were, cousins, Lonnie's and Warren's wife. I mean, they're all interrelated.
As I mentioned too, that was the case. The police officer from Socorro, Mexico, that changed J. Allen Hynek's mind about UFOs.
Exactly, and we've been there like 2 times because Chuck went back there to, you know, they have an emotional attachment to Allen Hynek. I do, and he does, and.
Last Friday, somebody called in and wanted to know if we believe aliens are walking among us. What do you think about that?
Oh, there's no doubt about that. There's no doubt. There is no doubt about that. Can I tell you a story?
Yeah, we've got some time, sure. ETs that are walking among us may be part of the hybridization program that we've heard so much about?
I think some are off limits, and I think some are hybridization, and I think I think it's all of the above. When people ask me things, it's not one thing or the other. We are an exhibitor of each one. It's all of us. All of the above. There's no definite yes or no. Because nobody can really know. I feel like saying, you people that are talking about aliens, did you have to sit down and have a cup of coffee with anybody?
Possible?
Do I think it's possible that there could be off-world people that have an agenda? many different races. So who are we talking about? Who can you tell me which one we're talking about?
That's a good point. Paula, in 2018, you wrote a book called Conversations with Colonel Corso. Let's talk a little bit about that, and then we'll take phone calls next. Listening to Coast to Coast AM on KSRO.
KSRO. Weekends on KSRO are all about our local community. Listen as we cover a wide variety of subjects live and local. Saturday mornings at 9, listen for Garden Talk. And then at 11, it's the Good Food Hour. Local talk, Saturdays on KSRO.
Team at the Center for Spiritual Living continues to create a world that works for everyone. The Center for Spiritual Living in Santa Rosa invites you back with two identical in-person services each Sunday at 9 and 11. From 10 to 11, visit the art show and Stepping Stones Books and Gifts. You can also view services on the website, Facebook, and YouTube. Go to cslsr.org for more information and updates. Attend Wednesday evening meditations from home via Zoom. Take advantage of the telephone prayer ministry. Access videos of Sunday messages and resources like the online affirmative prayer library covering a variety of subjects. That's cslsr.org. On behalf of Edward Fillion and the staff, we are immensely grateful for the dozens of individuals and teams working to keep us connected and on our spiritual path as we study, pray, love, support, and serve together. Listen to Spiritual Living with Edward Fillion, Sundays at 8:30 a.m. right here on KSRO.
DJ Sash and Glass is a full-service residential window and glass company. DJ's has served Sonoma County since 1960, and they're three generations strong. DJ specializes in custom shower doors. They'll get your window or shower door quote done and back to you within 48 hours. Add a touch of class to your glass. Call DJ's Sash and Glass at 546-7344 for your shower door replacement. Wilgin Court in Santa Rosa, online at djsglass.com.
News, traffic, weather, talk. Sonoma County's News Talk, KSRO Santa Rosa.
From ABC News, I'm Richard Cantu. It's the latest evidence of pandemic-related learning loss.
Nearly all of the nation's eighth graders fell behind in U.S. history and civics in 2022 compared with 2018 on the National Assessment for Education Progress. Just like math and reading scores, which have also plunged, teachers are blaming the onset of COVID-19 and its effects on students. Overall, only 13% of students performed at what's considered a proficient level in U.S. history last year. 46% of students are at the basic level, and 4 in 10 have knowledge that's below what's considered the basic level.
ABC Sherry Preston. Atlanta police investigators are trying to determine motive in Wednesday's mass shooting at a medical arts building. One person shot dead, 4 others wounded. Accused gunman Deion Sanders captured in Cobb County, an Atlanta suburb. Police Chief Stuart Van Hooser says they got a 911 call.
One real-time operator in particular saw a 911 call come in, literally said, I think this is going to be him. And there, it was mostly instinct, but a lot of it did have to do with where this call was coming in and where this individual was supposed to be.
The Federal Reserve raised its benchmark interest rate 0.25%, the 10th straight increase. The central bank says inflation in some sectors is starting to cool, but the overall rate, says Chairman Jerome Powell, is still too high.
Inflation remains well above our longer-run goal of 2%. Over the 12 months ending in March, prices rose 4.2%. Excluding the volatile food and energy categories, core prices rose 4.6%.
On the debt ceiling stalemate, White House spokeswoman Karine Jean-Pierre.
The president has been very clear that Congress must act. This is their constitutional duty to act, and we must avoid catastrophic threats to our economy.
President Biden to meet next week with the top four congressional leaders. The U.S. could default on its debt as early as June 1st. You're listening to ABC News.
If you have unfiled taxes or are in debt to the IRS, this is important news. The IRS just rolled out a new program to help struggling taxpayers more easily resolve their tax problems. It's called the Taxpayer Relief Initiative, and it opens up powerful new options for people looking to get back on the right track with the IRS. And no one knows this program like the professionals at Optima Tax Relief, America's most trusted tax resolution company. They've resolved over $1 billion in tax debt for their clients and have the expertise and experience to help you. One easy call to Optima can start the process, helping to put an end to your worries of wage garnishment, asset seizure, and other aggressive IRS actions. Make today the beginning of your fresh start with the IRS. Call the experts at Optima Tax Relief now for your free confidential consultation.
Call 800-343-6460. 800-343-6460. 800-343-6460.
Optima Tax Relief. For complete details, please visit OptimaTaxRelief.com.
Investigators in Okmulgee, Oklahoma, providing more information about Monday's discovery of seven bodies in a rural
police reported ahead
property. Authorities say Jesse McFadden, a registered sex offender, recently released after a long stretch in prison for rape, shot and killed his wife, her three teen daughters, and two teenage girls who were over for a sleepover before killing himself. Justin Webster is the father of 14-year-old victim Ivy.
I knew he had something to do with their disappearance. I was just hoping and praying that they would still be alive.
As for motive, Police Chief Joe Prentice.
The evidence is that Jesse McFadden murdered six people and then killed himself. Beyond that, I don't know what his thought process was.
Thumbing its nose at the state's Democratic Attorney General and civil libertarians, Danville, Illinois, banned the mailing or shipping of abortion pills. We're hearing from the actor Jamie Foxx, who previously has not spoken about the health issue that put him in the hospital recently.
Jamie Foxx has posted on Instagram for the first time since he was hospitalized April 10th due to, quote, medical complications. He writes, appreciate all the love, feeling blessed. Neither he nor his family has publicly said what happened to the Oscar-winning actor. Foxx TV says Nick Cannon will step in for Jamie Foxx on the game show Beat Shazam when the new season starts May 23rd.
Police reported ahead.
ABC's Jason Nathanson in Hollywood. This is ABC News.
Had enough of those little flies in your kitchen?
I did. That's why I got Zevo. I just plug in the trap, insert a cartridge, and let the light do all the work.
Zevo traps use blue and UV light to attract and trap flying insects with no odor, no mess, and no stress. Stop swatting and ditch the DIY traps. With Zevo, getting rid of bugs is as easy as
click, click, blue.
Zevo. People-friendly, bug-deadly.
I'm Richard Cantu, ABC News.
We know mornings are busy. We're here to get you what you need as quickly as we can. The big breaking stories of the day, weather and traffic. All of the information you need to start your day. Sonoma County's Morning News, making sure you're prepared for whatever the day might bring. Weekday mornings at 6. Wake up with KSRO.
Sonoma County's FM News Talk, KSRO, at 103.5 in Santa Rosa and 96.9 in Petaluma.